All right, Facebook friends, with me right now is St. Louis County Police Chief John Belmar, who's agreed to do an interview and talk about some issues. Chief Belmar, the county police, losing a $20 million judgment. Your reaction, first of all, to that?
Well, I would tell you that I was surprised by the reaction. But second of all, I would tell you that immediately what you have to do after that is pivot. You have to learn from it. You have to understand, okay, this just happened. We have to be in a position to move forward based on that. What can we learn from this? How can we become better? And I think that would be pretty much where I would have to be as far as the decision making of it. But again, I was surprised by the verdict, and I feel like that it's important for us right now to move forward.
The jury believed that there was a homophobic atmosphere at the department. Is that true, and do you think you share any responsibility in that?
No, you know, I don't believe that's true, and I would tell you that based on my decision-making on the police department, you know, regardless of race or sex or gender or sexual identity, national origin, whatever that may be, we don't make decisions like that. I don't make decisions like that. You know, this is the first type of litigation that has been brought forward such as this, but regardless of what I think, and regardless of what we know and believe here on the St. Louis County Police Department, because we're an incredibly diverse organization, we're proud of that, we serve a diverse community. Even the perception of that, however, is important, and we have to react to that perception. And we have to make sure that anybody out there understands that if they feel like that this is a police department and organization, whether it's the county police or any other, that has issues with equity and fairness, that we have to address those with a sense of urgency. And while we can point to solutions that we have enacted in the past, it's important to build on each one of those every day to move forward, because oftentimes perception is reality.
Certainly you've had to have felt under pressure in all this. Have you given any thought to stepping down, resigning?
No, I really haven't. Again, I've used the analogy before, a football coach doesn't leave during halftime. I think that's a bad idea. I've not seen that yet, regardless of the outcome of the game. And I think I have a responsibility. I think basically the way I'm wired is, I understand what responsibility looks like, I understand what leadership looks like, and I think I have an obligation to lead the department out of this crisis. And I think I have an obligation to work with the police department as we serve and protect our community to get even better than we have been before. We have a good track record on what we do and how we do it. We honestly do. And I think that's one of the things that perhaps people find surprising with the outcome of this most recent event. I think so. That's part of it, but I think again that we all have an obligation working together to make sure that nobody is left stranded. I think it's inappropriate to leave the department in any sort of a lurch, and I would never do that.
Do you think the county executive has overreacted with the shakeup of the police board?
Well, I think a lot's been made about the police board, but I think if you take a look at where we've been recently on the board, even since I've been the chief, there's been movement on the police board. So I don't think that's unusual to take a look at that. My message to you would simply be this. I appreciate the dedication of the citizens that have served on the St. Louis County Board of Police Commissioners most recently, at any time in the past for that matter. And I look forward to working with members of the board in the future who are nominated by the county executive, and it's well within Dr. Page's right to take a look at all of his boards and commission, certainly the Board of Police Commissioners. And the Board of Police Commissioners, as you know, is unique based on their authority found in the St. Louis County Charter. And I look forward, again, I view this as an opportunity to work with new members, while I certainly regard our most recent members and everything that they have provided as far as guidance and leadership on the department.
Do you believe the board is going to retain you? After all, you're looking at a new board.
Well, you are looking at that, and that's one of these things that certainly is in the right of the Board of Police Commissioners. But, you know, all I can do is my job. That's the easiest way to look at it. This isn't my first day, and I certainly respect the citizens that serve on the Board of Police Commissioners, whoever they may be, whenever that may be. But the fact of the matter is that I have an obligation to do the job the best of my ability, and I'll continue to do that.
Finally, message to the public. And message to your police department.
Right, I think the message to the public is simply this. We want to make sure that everybody understands that the St. Louis County Police Department has an obligation to treat anyone as we encounter during our mission to serve and protect with fairness, with equality. We will continue to do that. We have a track record to do that. And within the police department, I'll say this, everybody deserves to make sure that they have a seat and a voice at the table. That's also important. But I would say that I am very proud of the manner in which the St. Louis County Police Department, the men and women here, serve our communities. I appreciate what they do each and every day.
Final one, well, I got to ask this one. People are here on Facebook asking me about the battle against crime that seems probably to have taken a back seat in all this. What do you tell people? You look at these areas of St. Louis County that's been battling. You have been talking for a long time about the need to beef up the crime-fighting effort. What do you do differently now to try to get a handle on some of the crime we've been seeing, especially in North County?
Yeah, the funny thing is, under my leadership, we have more police officers patrolling the streets of St. Louis County than any time since 1955. And it's appropriate that we do so, because the people that live and work here in St. Louis County deserve nothing but the best police protection. I think sometimes, answering the phone a million times a year and going to 500,000 calls a year sometimes gets lost, because 99.9% of the work that the men and women of the police department do really is overlooked. But when we take a look, and you've heard me talk about it before, at the unfortunate amount of shootings in the region, certainly St. Louis County is part of that region, I would balance that against a clearance rate of homicides that's above 90% here in St. Louis County. So I'm proud of the work that's being done. I think we need to work harder. I think we have built, together with the public here in St. Louis County, an outstanding St. Louis County Police Department. We've added capacity. We've added different initiatives that help us protect and serve our citizen. We're looking at crime rates that are slowly on a downward trend, even better than flat. We would always like to see it be better than that, but the fact of the matter is St. Louis County is a very safe place to live and work, and we intend on keeping it that way.
Chief John Belmar. Chief, thank you for taking a few minutes to talk to me.
Thanks, Elliott. Appreciate you.